Hey gang, it's Gixerman01 on YouTube. Today we're going to start production on our Murphy style bed for the Tramper. I've got a couple frame rails that are actually for shelving units that I picked up at Lowe's. And then we're going to use some 2x3s as cross members and then put a real nice grade paneling on that for our bed. So we're going to get started on our bed for the Tramper, and I'll put out videos as we get them done. Okay gang, this is the brackets that raise and lower the bed in the Tramper. It's assisted with a gas shock here. Our rails will come off of this, the bed will lay on top of that, and that's how it'll fold up to the wall. We just run screws through it into the wall, and that's what holds it in place. So we'll get busy cutting our slats and cutting our plywood to put into our frame rails, get them painted, and then we'll put that all together and then mount it to our brackets, and then we'll mount the whole assembly in the Tramper. Now we've got the slats cut, we're gonna move on, try to cut our headboard and our footboard, and then we'll cut the plywood to go on top of that to put our bed on. So get busy cutting those.
We'll cut our headboard, and we're gonna cut our footboard, so we're just gonna mark it the same as our headboard. Make it square here. Already set the depth on my saw. I've got a chop saw, but it won't go 8 inches wide, so I got a circular saw. If you guys don't have a cordless circular saw, I suggest getting one. They're pretty handy. So we've got our headboard and our footboard cut. We've got all of our slats cut. So all we got left now to do is cut the plywood for the base. Okay, we got it all marked, and now we're going to cut off the excess. Make sure we don't cut off our sawhorse. Third hand would have been nice. Okay, so you can see we've put the wood slats on our plywood. We've got our first rail on. We're going to put the melamine back on it. And then once we put the other half of the melamine back on, we'll slide that channel on, and that will make our bed frame. So I'm going to get busy assembling all this, and I'll get a shot of it.
Okay, so now we've got our melamine board glued to the bottom of it. And, got it slid up under this channel. Glued it down, we capped the ends with the little plastic pieces, put our joint plastic down the middle of it, and then I went ahead and put the other frame rail on to cap the other side of it. And then I took a ratchet strap, sandwiched it all together, and then shot a couple screws in the bottom of it to keep it pulled in tight, and then we'll flip it over and we'll shoot our screws in the top of it, and then this thing's ready to mount the brackets. We've got it all flipped over, so now we're gonna run our screws in to the top of it. Now we can take our ratchet straps off. I'm gonna flip this back over, and then I'll start mounting the brackets to it. Hopefully I don't have to take those brackets back off to put the headboard and the footboard on it. So it's really coming together, looking like a factory built piece to go in our Tramper. Okay gang, what you're looking at is the bed
completely assembled, laying upside down on a set of sawhorses. We went ahead and assembled the brackets onto it. We've got the foot brace on it. All that's left to do is to paint my headboard and my footboard and screw those to the end of it, and then mount it to the wall in the tramper, and our Liftco bed will be complete. Put this into the tramper. I'm going to do a little video of the tramper again and cover some of the stuff that we've built and put in there in a little more detail than the previous video. So here we go. We've got our bed all put together. It's kind of late tonight, so we're going to wrap it up for this evening, but we'll be back out here tomorrow and finish this thing up, and we'll pull the tramper up and empty everything out there so we get a little room to work and mount this bed in the tramper tomorrow evening. I hope we get a little video of that. So stay tuned. We'll be finishing this thing up.
Okay, you guys saw the bunk getting made in the garage. I've now installed it in the tramper. Basically, which was just screwing these the back two pillars to the wall, and there is the fold down Murphy style bed. It's actually manufactured by Liftco, and then that is a Camping World innerspring mattress with a European top. It comes shipped to you in a box all rolled up, and then when you take it out of the shrink wrap, be careful because that thing about knock you down when it springs open. And that's as comfortable, almost as comfortable as sleeping in my bed at home. So this is the new bunk and mattress for the tramper. I'll demonstrate the operation of how it folds up. We got it really, you know, it fits just perfect in there. It folds up to the wall. There's only a few inches from the ceiling, so I couldn't ask for a better fit. Okay, so I'm gonna demonstrate how this all folds up. You got two arms to lock it in place. Latches and locks is into place there, and then we're able to store two motorcycles in here. We get just right at 6 feet of width left out of a 7-foot trailer, so it worked out pretty good. I don't think I could have asked for much better fit and finish on the way this thing went up against the wall there. I mean, I ran it all the way down. It just barely misses catching the floor. The only thing we bought that was pre-made were the brackets. The bottom of it is a melamine board from Lowe's. This is actually industrial shelving cross members that we use for the bracing. And then we put a sheet of cabinet grade plywood down on top with 2x3 slats inside the frame. You guys saw how all that was put together. And then we attached these brackets to it, put a headboard and a footboard on it, and then put our innerspring mattress on it. And I wish I'd done this from the very beginning for as far as a bed goes, but I didn't, kept not wanting to put anything on the wall, but this really worked out great. We camped more in it than what we actually haul motorcycles. When I thought it would be the other way around, I thought we'd haul motorcycles in this thing more than we camped in it. And as we go along, we keep making it a little more and a little more comfortable for camping. So yeah, I'm actually, you know, really stoked to get this bed put in here. I'm ready to go camping now. So we gotta service our AC unit and wash and wax this thing, and we're ready to camp. I'm gonna shoot a little video on the rest of the stuff we got in here. Like, we've got a flat screen TV on the wall. All the wirings ran behind the panels. And then what we did was for the flooring in this trailer, we put epoxy coating on the floor with the flake that you put on like a garage floor, and then we ran a sealer over top of that. And then my brother had a remnant of indoor-outdoor carpet,
we put down in here, and the idea behind that is it's just nicer when you're camping that you get out of bed and your bare feet, and it's on a carpet instead of on a cold painted floor. So just makes it a little more comfortable in here. We installed the window. This trailer originally didn't have a window in it, so I put the window in it, and then I'll flip a camera around here. I'll show you all the cabinets and the features we've got in the front of the trailer. A couple things we've done on the trailer. We put an AC unit. It actually has a heat bar in it, so we have heat and air in the trailer here. Like I said, we've put a flat screen TV with a built-in DVD player in it. I built the cabinets. I actually built the cabinets before I even had the trailer. I went to the dealership and got all the dimensions for this front section and started building the cabinets while they were actually building the trailer in Elkhart, Indiana. We put blue board in the ceiling, and then I put the melamine board on the ceiling to finish it out, and I just painted the walls. Looking back, what I probably should have done was insulate these walls before I went to all this trouble, but live and learn. We've got a big enough AC unit on it that it's not too big a deal. But I built the cabinets. I put some LED lighting in here. I put three 12-volt lights in the ceiling. And we've got a microwave. We've got a stereo. The stereo actually has a pocket so that you can put your iPhone or your iPod in it. And then you can run all your music off of that instead of having a CD player or a tape player on it. And then I went ahead and ran wiring outside the trailer and put a couple sockets out there. And then I've got some speakers that I've mounted magnets to the housing so that they actually stick up underneath onto the frame of the trailer. So we've got outside speakers while we're at the campground. I built the speaker boxes that are here, and then we put the diamond plate in it. We've got a stainless steel sink, which is just a small RV sink or a bar sink. And then we don't have hot and cold water in here, but we do have running water in here. I got a 7-gallon tank that I put outside the trailer, and then this actually just kind of drains onto the ground. Really all we do in here with this sink is we use it to wash up a little bit before bed or when we first get up in the morning, and then we'll brush your teeth and that kind of stuff. So it's not like we're really doing much anything that way with that water, so it's just gray water. Then we got a refrigerator, just a small 110 refrigerator. All the pump and everything is under this cabinet. Put in several outlets. We've got eight 110 outlets up here at the front of the trailer. That way we charge cell phones and iPods and laptops and that kind of stuff. We've got a HD antenna that I put on a mast on the tongue, and that's the other thing we have for our TV as far as getting to watch TV. And then this other side is just storage for stuff. And then also on this side, all the electrical components, our converter, our fuse, or our breaker box is all mounted on this side. I bought an RV converter so that it'll charge my batteries, and then I gave me several 12-volt outlets. The one thing I wish I'd done that I haven't done is put a couple cigarette lighter outlets in here, which would have been nice for charging different stuff too, and not tied up all of our 110 outlets. It really hasn't been too big an issue. It's just my wife and I. But what we have is enough room that two of us can sleep in here. If my son or my daughter come down and camp with us, then we can put two cots in here along with our bed, and we can all sleep in here pretty comfortably. But it's worked out pretty good. Like I said, I bought it thinking I was going to haul motorcycles more than I was going to camp in it. When it was said and done, we camp in this thing way more than we haul motorcycles. So it's worked out pretty good for us. And it's always a little bit of a spectacle when we show up at the campground. Everybody's curious what we got in that enclosed trailer when we pull in. Some of you see my camp kitchen video, which is part of why we went to this style bed instead of what we had before. We had a futon in here, which worked really well. I don't think it was quite, I know it's not as comfortable as what this bed's gonna be, but what it did let us do is take it out, and that way we didn't have anything permanently attached to the inside of the trailer. You know, I avoided doing that for the longest time. I wish I would've just went ahead and done this to start with. It really looks and works out pretty nice, and I look forward to using it. The other thing we did was put an awning on the outside, and it's just like everybody else's camper. You know, we get to the campground and pop our awning out. Little difference is we pull out a badass camp kitchen. I haven't seen anybody else pull out a camp kitchen like ours yet. So we've got a couple other projects in the works, a camp scooter and a camp cooler. Keep watching our videos, and those will be out here next couple weeks. We should get started back onto the camp scooter. So I thought I'd kind of do a little more in-depth video here on the inside of the trailer. I had a lot of people asking me about it. And again, if I have any regrets on it, I wish I'd insulated these walls. Being a black trailer, they get a little hot, but you know, it hasn't been a huge issue, but we've been camping when it was 105 degrees outside, and you know, that makes for a miserable camping trip if you can't go someplace to cool off. So that's basically it. This is the Tramper.